and but we have to still ensure that the fish reaches to the every nook and corner or even remote areas, so that fish consumption rate can be increased and enhanced, thereby the profit of income can be also extended. So before we start for the actual lecture on entrepreneurship opportunity in fish processing sector, we must look at what are all the aspects of fish processing sector, what are all the objectives, what are all the benefits one derive out of fish processing, and what concept and objectives we must ensure before going for the processing of fish. Now these are the advantages of and objectives of fish processing. Now by processing, we are able to effectively check the post-harvest losses. This is because we are intended to increase the acceptability of the fish. And similarly, we have to ensure also it reaches to every part of the place in our country. For that, we need to increase its shelf life. Now, how that can be attained, that we shall see later on. Now, fish processing, especially the seafood industry, opened up a new frontier to tap high income from foreign markets in many industrialized nations. Now, all over the world, seafood industry is growing to be a multi-billion dollar industry with immense potential for future. Even India is able to support that, because we are being overwhelming in fish export and products of, export of fish products, and we earn a lot of foreign exchange earning out of this export. So this is also one of the necessities of the fish processing, so that we are able to generate foreign exchange earning out of export. Then what are all are the strengths? Indian aquaculture produce of shrimp, fishery resource from the sea, which we used to collect from natural wild stock, the inland fish resource, which are resulting out of the fish culture from our pollution-free waters, pristine clear water, should fetch the premium price through the export of these fishes and to get the foreign markets into our command. So there has been, we talk about a lot of shrimp because it gives you a lot of, it is the most sought commodity from India for export. But even other fish resource, which we used to collect from the natural wild stock, from the ocean or sea adjoining to us, we used to harvest lot many important fishes like tuna, pomfret, mackerels, sardines, and the other food fishes also. Even ribbon fish on elasmobranchs, they also fetch a lot of price foreign exchange earning to them. Similarly, the fishes which are being rendered into surimi production is coming up very fast in our country. Then another very important resource which so far has been neglected, that somehow we could not make our road into our development into the processing of the fish from inland waters. Now, inland fish production is very high in our country. Since from the inception of culturing methods, fish breeding, the fish culture has been really revamped to whatever we have lost from the marine sector, we are able to produce it from inland fishery sector. But there is now a need that we should extend the avenues of fish processing to inland fishery sector also, so that we are able to fetch the premium export market out of the export of the inland fish also. Then the processed preserved fish, value added products, fish byproducts can be introduced anytime in the market. That is the reality. If we are able to somehow protect our stock of the harvest and even rendered value-added consumable product, fish products, and if we are able to preserve it and thereby bringing in the sort of the shelf life increment, can be introduced any time in the market. If it is introduced at the time of slack season of non-fishing days, these all value-added products, by-products and fish would fetch you a higher revenue and price. That is also another objective of fish processing. The fish processing industry holds tremendous manpower resource development. Whether it is industrialized fish processing sector or whether it is on a lower scale of, if not industrialized, but as a cottage industry, it has tremendous manpower resource development. A country like India, which is a developing country, where labor is in ample, why we should invest only on the technology which is not cost effective? Now, one problem of industrialized fishery sector is that somehow it comes up with very high scope and demand and with lot of expectations. But in longer run, it may run in losses. Because if somehow your target of receiving the raw material is not received, I mean in quantity, naturally you have to run with the cost of running cost of the industries. Then you have to update the quality standards, then wages, this all gets added up. And therefore, most of the industries, fish processing industries, they run in losses for a longer version of time. Why to adopt such a technology which is not beneficial? It is beneficial, but there are a lot of apprehensions. A country like India should focus on development of the traditional technology which is being acceptable to us since from the traditional times, from the times of our forefathers. A cottage industry, precisely that rendering of fish into the consumable products. It has a lot of local demand. Then focusing on the byproduct development, we are able to generate a lot of profit. And without going into the increase into the input cost, we are able to reap in harvest also in more way. So this is how our country, there's a lot of scope is there in the manpower resource development. And similarly, it may attend judiciously to the problem of unemployment. The extension of fish processing, byproduct development and value-added products among masses would provide self-employment. This is also a reality we should look at. Then what concept we derive from the fish processing? What are the concept and objectives of the fish preservation? One of the main objectives of fish processing is to retain the property of fish as near to fresh. Now, fresh is always a misleading term. What it looks fresh is not fresh inside. Fresh means quality-wise unimpaired, not deteriorated. Then how it can be achieved? To retain the property of its biomolecules so that it can be converted into the desirable products. What we aim for to develop the product that can be easily being achieved. To hinder or stop the spoilage bacteria or other microorganisms which bring about any change in the gastronomic or organoleptic quality of fish or stop ability to grow and produce any toxic metabolites. Friends, remember that we have to increase the shelf life. This is one of the main objectives, that we should be able to undertake all these activities with utmost hygienic standards. And nowadays, the standards which are being raised by the international market, the international quality standards, they are so stringent that has to be applied into industrialized fishery sector in order to achieve all this quality standard, raise this quality standard so that we are able to get the products of high quality needed for export. Now, these are the different objectives of fish preservation based on this, the principal avenues of fish processing are laid. Prior to determining the avenues of processing, some factor must be considered in total or to be predetermined. Now, this is prerequisite. before going for fishing, one have to expect a lot many things. One should get in, get the other informations also which are necessary, which enter into fish processing sector. How much is the production capacity of your unit? From where the raw material would come? Whether we are able to receive the sufficient quantity of raw material? How much time does it take to come, to receive the raw material? And how would be the running cost, running procedure would be, how long it would run? Whether we have the storage facilities also, that also has to be looked at. This is necessary because no portion of your harvest should go waste. The post-harvest losses, if at all has to be checked, we are necessarily being required to get this all information beforehand, before we go for processing. Then the other issues are, when we talk about microorganisms, it also includes pathogens. Pathogens also eliminate them so that they are not harmful to the consumers. To render longer storage of the product so that it should be available at the time of non-availability. To utilize the portion of fish that are generally discarded to produce the product of multifarious utility. Remember, no portion of the fish is a wastage. From every fish is the only entity, from its every portion one can utilize every portion to get some of the, there comes the importance of byproducts. The fish is such an entity that no portion of the fish goes waste if judiciously it is being utilized. Then to stop the degradation and nativity, originality of the fish by the enzymes inherent in the fish. That also one of the main objectives of arresting the fish spoilage. Now this all may be known to your all students and the faculty what strength India derives out of the very comprehensive aqueous resource at your command. Naturally, your country is very gifted. And this is all known, Indian coastline 1001. There might have been some of the changes here and there. So the Indian coastline 8,129 kilometers, continental shelf area 0.506. Then after the declaration of the EEZ and adoption by the EEZ regulation by our parliament in 1976, we are able to increase our sphere into the fishing in offshore region with the total extent of EEZ area of 2.02 million square kilometers, the brackish water 1.24 million. We are also amply gifted with the inland resource, area under tanks and ponds 2.3 million. At the area available for freshwater fish culture, 5.4 million. Area of reservoirs, 3.15 million hectares. Bills, oxbow lakes, 1.3 million hectares. Length of rivers, 1,97,021. There might have been some of the changes into this. Now, here comes the real strength of us. Imagine that there has been phenomenal increase into our fish landing. By the end of first five-year plan, it was just 0.839 million metric tons. By the year 2017, it has rose to 12.59 million metric tons. This was possible due to the judicious exploration of our water resource, may it be from marine sources or from inland sources. However, the scenario has changed drastically if one looks, analyze this production details. Even though there has been phenomenal growth into the fish landing in our country. For first 50 years after independence, we were dependent, heavily dependent on the share which was realized in major way from marine fishery sector. And all of us, we know, because of the overfishing or because of fishing from same and same water again, this balance is disturbed. We have been focusing out of generating maximum production of shrimp, which may be there into first 50 meters. We have churned our waters. We have harvested it to the extent that nothing is left as a quantum to our disposal. We have not been extending our fishing limits. when this was realized, when the production in actually get to be realized on a lower note from marine efficiency sector after 1996, by the year 2000, the production of the inland fish production caught up with the marine fish production. And since after the year 2000, there has been continuous increase, sustained high increase into inland fish landing, and a stalemate. If not, it is decreased, but it is not increased also. A stalemate or dwindling situation is there with the fluctuation from marine fishery sector. After this, we could realize that the importance of the extending our fishing limits. We couldn't even explore sufficiently our continental waters at the most. Now our marine mechanized fishing vessels, they are going up to 110 or maximum 120 meters. That is insufficient. We need to extend our limits into offshore in the pelagic and deep waters for fishing. We have to invent new methods of fishing so that on one hand, we are able to reduce the constant fishing pressure and the reduced fishing effort from the inshore waters, we may shift our attention. And thereby, we may find new other group of fishes which are acceptable, which may be of importance to us. And thereby, we are, by reducing this fishing pressure in the inshore waters up to first 100 meters, we are able to give the time in leave to recover the portion of the harvest. We are rejuvenating, we are able to rejuvenate our the fishing area to the first 100 meters if we extend our fishing to the new arena, in new virgin grounds of marine sector. However, the another reality is that we could increase the inland fish production, as it may be very relevant to, I mean, it may be visible to you. The growth rate of the percentage is always increasing. It may be almost above the 60% increase in there. The percentage share from marine side is always dwindling between 29.3 to 36.7%. Now, this has to be changed. Why this is needed to be changed? Because India, which is a very upcoming nation as far as... Hello? Jara main webinar mein hoon abhi, class mein. The important thing is that whatever the export we are doing, the majority of the export is coming from marine fishery sector. So we cannot anymore ignore the marine fishery sector. Export of the, I mean, from inland fishery sector is very negligible. So we have to keep on harnessing the marine water so that we are able to meet with the demand of the export to the international market. So we have to increase, we have to harness the marine fishery sector with the immediate emphasis. Now there, where we stand globally, India stands second in inland fish production, it stands sixth in position marine fish. India globally, so all of you know, in second position next to China. GDP from the fisheries is 1.4, and from national GDP to agriculture GDP fisheries is 5.4. Now, this has been the most redeemed feature of the Indian fishing industry. It is most redeemed. It is because we are able to stand with the export demand in the international market. If you take into consideration all agro-based commodity, what are we are exporting? We are exporting grains, vegetable oil, then hydrogenated oil, poultry, meat. But out of fish export, India's maximum revenue. As far as the revenue is concerned, earning of the foreign exchange earning is concerned, it is the fish, or fish export, or fish product export is putting its maximum contribution. Now you can imagine by 2008, our total export earning was 8,000 crore rupees, which has increased to 18,856 crores rupees in 2012-13. By every alternate year, you may find that this share into the, even if the quantity is not a major, but the revenue earned is really doubling. by the year 2014-15, over 10 lakh tons of fish was exported and 33,441 crores of rupees. Now, by year 2017, our export earning has gone over 45,106 crores of rupees. I'm yet to add some more recent figures, but you can imagine that if the export earning was 8,000 crore rupees in the year 2008, by the 2017-18, it has almost increased over 5 to 6 times. It is 45,106 crores of rupee. That is the major achievement of India. Now, status of fish processing. This may not be that much of importance, but just let's say consumed in fresh form 65%, cured form 14%, frozen form 6.6, reduced in manure and byproduct. Hello, am I audible to you all? Let me check it. Let me have the feedback. May I sunai de raha?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Reduced in manure and byproduct 8%, special processing 2%. Out of export oriented, the entire export lot is from frozen. Frozen fish, shellfish, over 64%, frozen shrimp, 44%, frozen fish, 20%, frozen squid, 7%, frozen cuttlefish, 9%. Now, this is how the share in quantity wise. This is fish as in general. That is 34%. Next is shrimp, but it is the single largest commodity. Then squid 9%, cuttlefish 10%, dried 3%, others 13%. Now, in terms of share value, you see the first position, India's export is dependent heavily on shrimp. We almost earn 67% of your export earning from shrimp. Just very little comes from 10% on fish, 6% from squid, 7% from cuttlefish, 2% from dried, and 8% from other items. Now, there have been many innumerable reasons of the fish spoilage. Now, exactly why you go to any physician, he'll tell you to have fish in your diet. Why? It is because the fish is nutritionally very important. It is one of the easiest source of protein to be taken. And the simplest kind of a protein. Beside protein in high, it fulfills majority of the amino acid demand which your body needs, even essential amino acids. Very little fat, carbohydrate around 2%, 3%. Then it is excellent source of omega-3, polyunsaturated fatty acids, PUFA, mainly from marine fish. It is a rich source of vitamins and minerals. Machli banane mein aasan, pakane mein, khane mein aasan, pachane mein aasan. Why? How much time does it take to prepare the fish? Let me have feedback. Kitna der lagta hai machli banne mein? How much time does it take to cook the fish? Huh? Okay. If you have everything at your command, fish is there, clean fish, then you whatever the spices you want to put, that you mix it well. Take fry pan, allow the oil to get boiled, and just keep the pieces of fish. It just takes 2 to 3, 3 to 4 minutes time to cook the fish. How much time does it take to cook the chicken? If it is a soft chicken, like broiler, cockerel. Nowadays, the broiler also, the meat is very hard. This variety is changed. The auto mutation is there. But still, they say half an hour or so. If Kadaknath is more major or desi is type, it takes around 45 minutes. Meat, it takes around the entire procedure of preparation changes. You go for cooking the meat, goat meat first, and then you add spices. And it takes a lot of time to cook the goat meat and further also. Why this difference? Why fish it gets cooked up very early? It is because of the existence of simplest kind of protein. These protein bonds are highly complicated. If one goes on to chicken or Kadaknath or say for meat or beef, it takes time to get separated. And that is why machli banane mein aasan. What has been its greatest attribute? It is curse also. You put fish, chicken and meat early to spoil would be the fish, because fish is one of the most vulnerable of vulnerable for spoilage food atoms. It is because it is aqueous. Then similarly, what has been its greatest attribute? That simplest kind of protein availability is there. The same simpliness and this simplest kind of protein, it doesn't take time to get denaturated. On one side it is beneficial, but on another side it is hazardous. The protein denaturation, it happens early. That is why fish, it spoils very early. Then when we go for the proximate composition of the fish, there are many products of multifarious utility one can attain because of the inherent presence of some of the very renowned metals, minerals, which can be rendered into fish byproducts. Even after eating the fish, fish is not heavier. It gets assimilated also very quickly, unlike other meat atoms. It takes time for digestion. Fish is very early to digest and assimilate. So these are the attributes and some of the, as far as the spoilage is concerned, fish is most vulnerable. Now these are all the common causes of the spoilage it may run, but this all process sets in the fish very early. Even though if it may be common for other meat products, but all these processes sets in the fish very early. Loss of immune system after death, shortening of fish muscle due to rigor mortis, activation of bacteria at high temperature and no oxygen, leaching of digestive enzymes and protein and lipid oxygen, reduction of ATP, this all you know. Now, if in, and according to statistical information which have been received so long recently in the country, about 30% of the total fish is harvested and it goes to waste. Our planning is wrong. Our timing is wrong. In marine fishery sector, the mackerel, it gets sold around the price of 30, 40 rupee kg. But at the season of gulp, you go to October, November and these months, you find tons and tons of the mackerel washed down to the shore without any of the utilization. No processing methods are adopted. The price crashes to 2 to 4 rupees, 5 rupees per kg. You produce that much which you are able to take use for. Why go for wastage? This is absolutely a ridiculous planning. Well, what happened to the Andhra people? They sowed in tomato, thinking that the tomato would make them richer. But when actual crop came, they were to spend more wages on plucking tomato from the plant rather than earning the profit. This is the failure of your planning. Then losses generally result from other sources, discarding as far as the marine fish is concerned, discarding of bycatch from the shrimp trawler, losses due to incomplete utilization, conservation into finished goods, losses due to quality deterioration between harvest and consumption. Then the two important T enter into the processing is T for time and T for temperature. There should not be any time lapse between the harvest and actual procedures taken in. Temperature, cold. It is most prints icing when you aim at to preserving the fish to maximum up to 6 hours to meet with the local demand of the supply or to the processing center or to the market or door to door. Slow freezing, where you aim at decreasing temperature from 0 to -8 degrees Celsius, and thereby you aim to go for about 1.5 months to maximum up to 3 months of shelf life. Aqueo freezing, this is very advanced method where you aim to decrease the temperature to -20 minus 30, minus 40, and do that all. Since you are fishes, you may be known about hot treatment. Cooking is the easiest way. It eliminates all kind of bacteria after the cooking to the boiling point. Smoking also, I mean, all barbecue or smoked products or tandoor products are very common nowadays. Smoking is a frying, also curing also one of the very important methods of preservation. Now, these are all the products. I mean, I want to focus with my experience of entrepreneurship that is coming. But before that, these are some of the products, frozen fish fillet, frozen prawns. These are some of the surmi items, very high surmi. No, surmi is a kind of fish paneer. Now, which can be utilized into variety of food products. The acceptability of the fish as a food increased after the surmi production. Surmi is an intermediate product which is exported to the countries like Japan, China for the rendering to Kamaboko products. There are many local products which are being very popular in Japan. In India also, some products are coming up. But we are the one of, we happen to be, imagine that some 20 years before, there was only one surmi plant. It was started by Gadre brothers in Ratnagiri. Now there are over a dozen of surmi plants are there. Now how much money, a major chunk of money is being accepted? Because variety of the franchise of the food items can be prepared out of the surmi. These are some of the products. These are the fish fingers, fish balls, fish patties, fish sausage, fish wafers, fish pickle, fish soup powder, and fish fried different. Now canning is now not much is being popularized. Now it is being replaced by MAP or the retort pouch. Packaging is more common. Now this is fish in Kerala style. All these products, even all traditional products like papad and all can be made out of fish. Now these are the products, byproducts. You may be known about, your teachers may be dealing with it, the fish protein concentrate, fish soup powder, fish meal, fish liver oil, fish hydrolysate, fish moss and azinga, pearl essence, glucosamine and agar, fish sauce, fish insulation, pharmaceutical product. You may be known variety of products, especially chitin, chitosan. These products have come in a major way. About 300 derivatives of the very exclusive products can be derived out of the chitin and chitosan. And it is coming up very fast, which is being rendered from the chitin of the shrimp. Now this is shark fin rays, fish ensilage, chitin and chitosan, seaweed agar, icing glass. These are the traditional conventional methods of fish drying and cured products. Now there, here I want to focus at. Now we have the experiential learning program funded by ICR, and we have got around over 90 lakhs of rupees. In fact, I happen to be the chairman appointed by ICR to lay down or to prepare the experiential learning project in fish processing sector. I was chairman, and we could draft it for all the universities, and we are also one of the beneficiaries. Now yearly, we offer the students, we have two ELP modules. One is for aqua farming, and which may go for the fish seed production and raising of the fish to the table fish. Another is post-harvest technology. Now our students, because since the intake capacity is around 20, the maximum 10 or sometimes 12 students comes to us. But imagine that you'll be surprised that how successful ELP module is there for them. It was introduced, it is, we offer them into the last semester, where for about 6 months they are engaged. And then they have been given freedom to prepare, they use your own recipe and make the product and sell it on their own. The product which is developed this year, next year it would be the it would be the traditional product. They have to keep on adding and inventing the new products, and by this way we could increase our product making to a variety of the food items. the recipe which are not even common. I mean, they may be common to as far as the our traditional fish culture, fish cutlet and other the easiest way of rendering of the fish is being there, to the westernized product also the students are making. So I'm just want to give you the glimpse and economics of how successful our ELP program is. Now, this introduction, it may be known to you. India is the second largest fish producing country in the world with the production of 12.59. Total production 8.92 from inland and the marine water, some 3.8. Out of the total fish caught, around 35% undergoes processing. Fish is the cheapest soda protein, and all this known to you. Standard fish processing method, I am to check or retard the action of micro, increase the shelf life, and the product of other fish includes value addition of fish. Today is the era of the food technology, and many inventions are done in the food processing and value addition. Value added products enhance the quality and its price, and their new form always lures the buyers. There is heavy demand of such acceptable products. Seeing the prospect and wide applicability of this field, and experience and learning course of the fish processing was introduced, and this was introduced to us. Now, innovative value-added fish products. Now, you just see. This is fish head one, prepared by our students. Okay. Then, fish bread roll. This is a French dish, fish semolina sandwich. Fish ravioli, this is also another French. Yearly, about three to four students, they go to France. And from experiential learning, two students, they go to France for the stay for about 2.5 to 3 months. And there they learn. The top two to three students from processing, they go. And from aquaculture, they go to France for the duration of 3 months. And this was the MOU signed with the fisheries, which has now extended to other faculties also. Like the bunch of the students, some 30 to 40 students, 30 to 40 students, they go to France. Agriculture, they are assigned to the agriculture institutes, engineering institutes, fisheries institute, depending on their this thing. So a wide coverage is being given for the with the French ministry. Fish ravioli, fish kima rice, fish pinwheels, marinated fish chunks, fish frankie, fish dabeli is a Gujarati dish. Now, conventional also value-added fish products, they make fish cutlets, that fish burger, fish manchurian, fish balls, fish momos. Now, cost, you just see that. Now, how successful we to the extent we ensure that they are not on holidays. It's not a free time for them. Every one of them, they have to come and give attendance. Every Saturdays and no holidays. And our market outlet is the campus only. So we were venturing. I mean, your major sale points were some different faculties, KISOCs, and then to supply to various hostels. In spite of that, the demand is so overwhelming. And then during Kisan Mela time, people are mad for all these products. Within no time, you go with the product, within 15 minutes, half an hour is finished. The sale value, it reaches to more than 30,000 rupees in 2-3 days. That is the kind of response we get. Now we are getting them the one mobile van also shortly to sell their products to the nearby areas of Rudrapur and Haldwani. They would maintain their logbook. The students only would drive so that the cost of driver is saved. And we used to deduct whatever we give to them, but the maximum profit goes to the student. Now, yearly, it goes to, this is the test panel of ours. Now, profit analysis, total input cost, this was for that batch. Hello? हाँ मेरी आवाज आ रही है?
यस सर।
अरे प्रॉफिट एनालिसिस, जो टोटल इनपुट कॉस्ट वाज 40,881, टोटल आउटपुट कॉस्ट 1,15,854, प्रॉफिट टोटल टोटल इनपुट कॉस्ट इज दिस मच रुपीज 74,970, प्रॉफिट पर पर्सन 10,7,400 इन वन ऑफ द ईयर वी क्रॉस्ड इवन 10,000 रुपीज पर पर्सन पर मंथ पर स्टूडेंट पर मंथ. This is how the overwhelming demand of these products is coming up. Of course, however, we have sustained great loss due to the COVID defect, and that year before this also was slightly not productive. But in some of the year, it is very overwhelming, and this is how there is lot of profitability. The entrepreneurship lure is there for. Just see, these are all the products which you can prepare at your home. And you can make it. I mean, the market is always ready for you. They are ready to accept that is there. You may your I mean I have seen in your faculty also you also prepare lot many products, and that has to be improvised. So the profit would come once you, I mean, you have to resolve 2-3 issues. By rendering these products, you are taking as a fish as a food too. You are spreading among the masses. You are making the fish consumption more stronger. You are attending the problem of malnutrition. In terms of profitability, you are able to gain lot of incentives through profit. And similarly, fish is taken to every place. It is easy to be taken. And then it has also it not necessarily these all products are to be freshly eaten. By applying some freezing, flash frying and freezing, this thing you can extend the shelf life of the cutlet and other these products also. There is a lot of storage values also there. Suppose you have made on one particular day the product which is large in number. जितना सेल हुआ सेल हुआ बचा हुआ आपने फ्रोजन रखा उसको एक हफ्ते बाद 15-15 हम लोग तो 20-20 दिन बाद भी हम लोग हमने ट्राई किया हमारा हो गया. व्हाट वी यूज्ड टू डू, वी टेक दिस कटलेट्स एंड ऑल एंड इफ द रिमेन कटलेट वी फ्लैश फ्राई इट, वी पुट इट इन टू पॉलिथिन एंड वी गो फॉर वैक्यूम पैकेजिंग एंड देन वी स्टोर इट टू -20 टू -50 डिग्री सेंटीग्रेड एंड that this with this even after 1 and 1.5 month all the product is able to be safer for the consumption. So this is what our experience is. So this was the conclusion. During the tenure of 6 months under experiential learning program, we have learned about different management practice such as maintain our cost if a profit ratio to be balanced by balancing our input and output ratio. By doing market survey in local areas, we have all these necessities have gone into value-added products, and this has gone to the potential market for further. This thing it has to be improvised. Then, even adverse situations like unavailability of raw materials, sometimes it happens to us. Sometimes the major supply comes from our fish farm, but we may go for reservoirs. Actually, the Pandagar is blessed with surrounding lot many reservoirs. So I ask my students, if the fish is not available, you go for in a major way and you use any kind of fish available from reservoir. The mantra is you go for the utilization. Why all major crops, even those unknown fishes where the flesh is in substantial amount, you where the cost is more less. Raw material, and then you prepare out of it, then the profit of margin would be more. So this is how our experience is. Thank you very much for listening to me. For if any doubts are there, kindly let me know. Thank you Ajit, thank you Prabhjit and your faculty staff, your students.
Thank you sir.
Thank you, sir, for your valuable lecture, and definitely it has enlightened our knowledge, particularly in the field of fish processing sector. So there are lot of scope to adopt fish processing and fisheries as a business. Okay, sir. So now the forum is open to all. If any student have any query, any question, they can ask. Any student? Question from any student? They can ask. Dear students,
sir, I think we don't have any even in the chat box, so you can move ahead.
So anyhow, so sir, I because due to some technical issue, I forgot to introduce you formally. So Dr. Upadhyay, AK Upadhyay, he is my teacher, mentor. And I, even though I work as a SRF under him in one of the project in 2002 and 2003, I worked under him. It was, I think, evaluation of the performance of different diets using key engine. This was a
enzyme
project. So now I want to introduce him formally, because there are so many achievements on the name of him. He is a professor and head at College of Fisheries, Pantnagar.
I was former dean also.
Former dean also, sir. And he is a active member of various committees, society, and one of the society, or you are member of UGAC expert committee for the evaluation of 10th plan and allocation for general development grant under 11th plan for UGC governed university. Sir, you are also member of National Knowledge Commission of Government of India for Fisheries Development and Production. Sir, you are also member of Seafood Society of Ampida, Cochin. Sir, you are also international, having some many international assignments, and particularly you have established the international collaboration of College of Fisheries, Pantnagar, with Legata Louis Pasteur, Human Dew, Francinet, La Courage University, France. And he is also visiting Faculty of Agriculture, Food and Environmental Quality Sciences, Hebrew University, Jerusalem, Israel. Sir, you are also a member of Fishery Society of British Isles, Swaston, Cambridge. Sir, you are instrumental to establish fish processing facility at College of Fisheries, Pantnagar, under the experiential learning program. And it is possible only because of you. If you are not there, definitely means it is very difficult. I can understand it is very difficult to establish such kind of processing facility in a college. Sir has been awarded with various awards, particularly some of them are, he's a national fellow awardee from Zoological Society of India. He is best eminent scientist awarded with the gold medal by Zoological Society of India. Sir has written more than you have handled more than 8 research projects, and you have published 4 books besides various research papers of national and international repute. So it is my privilege to welcome you. And in the meantime, if any student want to ask any question, they can ask. So these are some of the awards. I think Vijayashree Award is also on the name of you, sir. You are also awarded with a Vijayashree Award. And you started your academic life from College of Fisheries, Ratnagiri. Later on, you joined College of Fisheries, Pantnagar. So anyhow, now it's time to say thanks to all of you, and particularly, sir, Dr. AK Upadhyay, sir, for enlightening our knowledge to upgrade our information in the field of fish processing sector. I also want to extend my sincere thanks to our worthy Vice Chancellor, Dr. Inderjeet Singh, and Dean College of Veterinary Sciences, Dr. S.P.S. Gumman, Dean College of Fisheries, Dr. Meera D. Ansal. And I also want to extend my sincere thanks to all of the students who joined this webinar for listening this webinar patiently. I also pay my special thanks to my colleagues, particularly Dr. Prabhjit, Dr. Vijay Reddy, and Madam Amandeep Kaur for their constant support. Whenever I asked, they provide all the information, they encouraged, and they helped me to organize this webinar very well. With this, I want to say my thanks to all of them, if I forget the name at this moment. Dear students,
my last some few words to you all.
Yes, sir.
I'm thankful to your Honorable Vice Chancellor, Dr. Inderjeet Singh, for providing me an opportunity to be there of the part of the webinar. Then to your Dean, College of Veterinary Science, your entire faculty is known to me, Dr. Ajit Singh, Prabhjit Singh, and your other staff, which are all known to me, Madam Kaur, and everyone, so thankful to you and the students for the knowledge sharing. Thank you very much to all of you. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you. Thank you, sir. So, dear students, so tomorrow we will have another speaker, and all of you are requested to join the webinar at 10:15 sharp. So, and now, Ms. Amandeep Kaur will share one link. You have to give your feedback on this link. And with this, today's webinar now it is over, because we have because after this we have another seminar on same platform. So now with this webinar is over. If Dr.
Dr. Ajit, sir, I think we forgot to thank one important guest, Dr. Vipul, who might have helped with all the technical things with Upadhyay sir. So please convey our heartfelt thanks to Dr. Vipul Gupta sir also, because we know, sir.
I sincerely apologize for that. I really, it is very thankful, means I'm very thankful to Dr. Vipul Gupta to help to organize this webinar in such a better manner. And I really apologize for that, because of his help, it is difficult to manage this webinar. Thank you, sir. Thank you, Vipul Gupta, sir.
Thank you, Upadhyay, sir. And Abhinandan and sir, heartfelt thanks that you spared your time from your busy schedule, sir. I think sir has left.
Now we can close, yes. Tomorrow we will meet again, and the webinar will start at 10:15 sharp. So students, please join it on time.